In 2021, when the Rotary Moment Show finally went on air, one of the first things we thought of was we must show what Rotary is. We must show those proud moments when we are very, very happy with what we've achieved in our society. Rotary has since 99 years ago been here in Uganda, been transitioning power. Next year we make 100 years here in Uganda. We shall install our 100th district conference and district governor next year in Jinja. But here today, on the 32nd president of the Rotary Club of Kampala Central, it is a great pleasure for me as Carol, because I was a member of the baby club, the Rotary Club of Kampala Central, the ROC. And that is how the Rotarian I am today. From the ROC, the Rotarians in Kampala Central always taught us what it was to follow the rules, to follow the goals of Rotary, to follow what Rotary is. And I'm very proud to be here at the installation of President Marion as she takes the chain from President Francis. You will hear the proud moments of achievements from President Francis as he and showing us what he has achieved this year. And from President Marion, you will be able to hear what she promises to do next year. It is a proud moment for me, and welcome to the Rotary Moment Show. I'm still Carol Chaze Kakoza, and I welcome you here on screens to watch with us as we transition power or leadership from one president to the other after just 1 year. The guest of honor tonight is a deputy speaker, Thomas Tayewa, who is very instrumental in this club, an honorary member who is also being awarded as major donor number 2. That means that you've given to the Rotary Foundation 20,000 and beyond every year. It is amazing to be in Rotary this night. Why? Because for whatever dollar that you are giving to Rotary, another child who is suffering from malaria is being healed. A child who has no clothes is getting a blanket. A child that doesn't have education will be able to get literacy. An environment that has no trees will be able to get trees that are planted. Welcome to the Rotary Moment Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, I call fellowship to order. I welcome you once again. Thank you very much for coming, and thank you for being very good friends of the Rotary Club of Kampala Central. We shall have the grace, led by Rotarian Susan Katono, the loyal toast by Rotarian Frederick, the four-way test by Rotarian John, and the object of Rotary will be led by Rotarian Wilson. I invite you to stand as we ask Rotarian Susan to lead the grace. Please be upstanding.
Let's humble ourselves. Dear Lord, for what we have received and about to receive, may you truly make us thankful and ever mindful of the needs of others. Amen.
Thank you, President, fellow Rotarians, Rotaractors, Interactors, guests. Let's toast to the good health of His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Uganda.
Thank you, President. All the things we think, say, or do, first, is that true? Second, is it fair at all concerned? Third, will we learn better friendships? And fourth, will it be beneficial to all concerned?
Thank you, President, our guests and members of this club. The object of Rotary is to encourage and foster the ideal of service as a basis of wealthy enterprise, and to encourage and foster four things. First, the development of acquaintance as an opportunity for service. Second, high ethical standards in business and professions, recognition of the worthiness of all useful professions, and the dignifying of each Rotarian's occupation as an opportunity to serve society. Third, the application of the ideal of service in Rotarian's personal business and community life. And lastly, the advancement, international understanding, goodwill, and peace through the world of fellowship, business, and professional persons united in the ideal of service.
Dear guests, I believe I'll have to calm down. And as I do that, allow me invite the board that I've worked with since June to come and join me. The protocol has been observed. I would like to stand on that. Dear guests, I welcome you to this installation ceremony. I thank the members of this Green Club for seeing me fit to be their 31st president. I hope I have met your expectations. Together with my board that is here, we have done quite a lot, and I thank them. I would like to quickly introduce them. I'll actually give them an opportunity to introduce themselves, and then I'll proceed with my short remarks. We'll begin from this side.
Julian Annette Kaganzi. I was the immediate past president, club trainer. Thank you.
Robert Sebugwao, popularly known as Coach Bob, Sergeant at Arms.
Mark Henry Rubarenzia, Secretary / CEO.
I'm Naturinda Sheila. I was the Deputy President and M&E.
John Tumsime. I've been a membership director.
Susan Katono, Chair, TRF.
Dorothy Chiaga, in charge of fundraising. Thank you.
Thank you, team. I would like to invite our Rotarian Ben. He's our Mission Green Officer, Ben Kibumba. Please come and join us here. And thank you. Together with this team, we have done a number of things this year. We've organized medical camps, especially in Lukwanga. We have uplifted the boy child in Buija, that is in PG district. We've supported youths in Lukwanga. This is our Adopt a Village project, and we've worked with them almost since this club started. We have implemented global grants, and we've also attracted new members to the club. During our year, with the support of our grants team, we've been able to qualify for grants, but we've also had two grants approved and handed over to us for implementation. One of that is Chengera Women's Hospital, which shall be beginning soon. And we have also started on the MCH project that is being implemented in over 7 districts around Uganda. We have maintained partnerships, and we have also attracted new partners in form of companies and other organizations, and we shall continue to attract more. I could never have done this alone. I thank you, dear members of the board, for being there to support me, and I thank you for the dedication and the time that you've put into this. We received an RI citation, and we managed to scoop 3 awards at the recently concluded DISCON. These wins belong to us all. Congratulations, and I thank you so much. I would like to thank my AG, Anthony. Thank you very much for providing guidance to the club. On so many occasions, we've called him at short notice, and every time he has said, "My president, I'll be there." Thank you very much, AG Anthony. And we look forward to a bigger relationship with you. Please keep with us, and we hope you will not stop being with us. I thank the DG, Edward Kakembo Nsubuga. I have looked up to him for quite some time, and I've been glad to serve under him as president and with him leading as the district governor. I want to thank my most trusted advisors. I'll begin with PP Lydia. Please stand up for recognition. I'd also like to thank past president Charles. Thank you very much for the advisory service you provided. And I want to thank my VP and advisor. She's been in so many categories. PP Shira Naturinda. For those of you who know these advisors, you know when they tell you something, you don't have to think about it. It is just the right thing. And I thank them. They've been there to support us. They've been there to advise us. And I'm glad that we've worked with them very well. I would like to call upon my sister and incoming president, Amarion, to take advantage of this great team, especially of past presidents, for advice and guidance. I thank MD Patrick Kunowa. PK. Yes, please appreciate him. MD made my idea of live and quality online fellowships come to life. And he did this even before I requested him. Let's appreciate him once again. He provided all the equipment we needed. And right now, when you join us online, it will be as good as physical fellowship here at Africana. Thank you very much, MD. Patrick. I would like to appreciate Rotaractor Abbas. Abbas, where are you? Now, Rotaractor Abbas has literally moved business in the club. He has served diligently. He has managed our social media pages, and he has delivered quality fellowship video and audio to all members that have not managed to make it physically. Thank you very much, Abbas. We appreciate you, and we encourage you to keep with us. To my friend and sister, President Marion, I wish you success as you lead this club. I'm always available to provide support whenever you need it. I'm just a call away. These members of the Green Club are committed, and they are very supportive. And if you tap into their capacities, they'll walk with you and make your leadership journey worthwhile. I thank my dear wife, Carol. She's not managed to be here. She has supported me quite well. As you know, presidency comes with a lot of demands, and she has supported me to ensure that I meet this. And I also want to thank my two girls, Melanie and Marian. They have had to bear with my absence as I carried out our club activities. And they would not manage to be here because of school, but I'm glad that they provided support. Lastly, I would like to thank God. Without his will, we wouldn't all be here. And I want to thank you very much and say God bless you and enjoy the evening. I would like you to give me a minute to hand over a token of appreciation to the following. I would begin with the board members and advisors.
This is one club that I'll tell you I hold very dear to my heart. Why? Because I was supposed to have joined this particular club. Why? Because I come from the Rotaract Club of Kampala Central. That is my Rotaract Club, and that's where I was groomed to become the Rotarian I am. And it gives me a lot of pleasure to introduce to you the incoming president, the 32nd president of Central.
Yes.
Welcome to the Rotary Moment Show, President-elect Marion Muyobo. Welcome. There's also something else maybe I should talk about. She, it, club as your aunt, and that is the wife of a Rotarian in your club. So she's going to serve in many capacities. She is an aunt and I'm in my club, but she's also the president. Welcome to the Rotary. President, I'm going to be very brief because we must hear from you as we start this installation. And I have three questions that I would love you to just talk about freely. I'm not going to interject. The first one is, what is your strategy? What is that you're going to do this year that will make President Marion stand out? What is that we're going to hear about Kampala Central that will make it that outstanding club? This year, you had the Lieutenant Governor. Who are we having this year from at the district level? My second question is that you have 74 members in your club. Are you going to have more members? What is that you're going to do this year? And what is your communication to your 74 members? My last question is that to our dear district governor. She has a lot that she's passionate about. How are you planning to tackle that, that vision that she has for the district? If you can give me those three, I will let you go along and get your chain as president.
Okay, thank you much. Yeah. Delighted to be here today. The 32nd president of the Rotary Central. I've been with this club for 18
years.
Wow. So 32 years old, and I'm 18 years. It's quite commendable.
Yes.
So what took me so long?
Yeah.
There had to be time for me to come to this club. This club, as you've mentioned, is a very strong club, Kampala Central. And for this, the year that I'm starting on the 1st of July, I am going to be focused on all the seven areas of focus. But the primary one has been we are known as a green club.
Yes.
We've done a lot of tree planting, and our target is actually 50,000 trees.
Whoa!
Very audacious target,
yes.
And we know we can definitely make this target. Another strategy for us is we have a lot of global grants which we have gotten approved. But we need to execute them.
Yes.
A lot of clubs have problems with execution. They actually receive this, but they don't execute. So we are going to not do a lot of fundraising activities, but spend a lot of time executing, implementing. One of them is in Chengera. It's maternal and child health, which is another area of focus. And we are going to also have an element of tree planting in this project. Have a basic education project that we're going to be undertaking in partnership with another club, the Rotary E-Global Uganda Club. It is in Chenjojo, so we also partners in that. It has different elements, and we also have a water and sanitation initiative on top of all the other activities that we are going to be doing. There is a strong medical outreach initiative that we undertake in a community, a Rotary community core in Lukwanga. So Lukwanga is on within a little bit out of Kampala, not more than an hour's drive. So we have a community there, and we've been supporting that community with Lubiri Secondary School, not the Lubiri of
Kampala.
So we actually do have a number of initiatives in that. So within that, we've given them books, we've done planting and some water projects. So we want more tree planting in the communities in Lukwanga. But the medical outreach is when we go, we have a pharmacy, tech doctors. We have a lot of doctors in our club.
Okay.
So we want to actually that in this year. Another key strategy that we are going to have is related to we have to grow. have a target of 80 members. If the 74, if the 74 become 70, we have to grow to get to 80. It's important that we create very, we attract very good talent, and we retain, have very engaging for the Rotary. We want to also focus on our Rotaractors. Rotaractors are a very good way. You mentioned that you were with The Rock.
Yes.
The Rock is our baby club.
Yes.
I am going to the president of the baby club, supportive of them by participating in their initiatives, helping them also with their fundraising, but also making sure they participate. So, to have committees, and these committees will include. We have a very strong board, and from a governance point of view, the mistakes that Rotarians tend to make and Rotary clubs make is they do not follow the procedures.
Yes.
You, if you have a strategy, you follow the strategy. If you have if you're supposed to have a structure in your organization, like where you work, it's the same. So we need to make sure. So, with if we take now what the district governor wants to focus on, she wants to focus on membership, the Rotarian, and the quality Rotarians building. It is also one of the areas that we are going.
Your final remarks are very, very important. Why? Because you have a lovely setup here today.
Okay.
Yeah. What are those final shots?
My final shots have definitely got to be sustainability, creativity, and Rotary in Uganda, that to give back to humanity. Thank you.
Well, that's the Rotary Club of Kampala Central. Congratulations on first of all becoming EE and today taking that chain. She's going to be the 32nd president of the Rotary Club of Kampala Central, my mother club at heart.
Thank you once again. Tonight I'm privileged to introduce our good friend, Nathan. Come over. Nathan Moya Kamba joined Rotaract in 2009 and retired from Rotaract in 2019 and was sent off by DG Xavier. He is currently working with Post Bank as manager quality assurance. He is a past president of Rotaract Club of Kampala Central. He is a past Rotaract country chair 2016-2017. And here I present Nathan to the club. I am going to welcome DGN Chitakuli to do the norms. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Since Nathan, you are a former Rotaractor, I'll invite your family, Swan. But I'd like to invite the senior Rotaractors here, like past district Rotary representatives here, to come and join me. And Emmanuel. Where is Jacob? Has he disappeared? So Nathan, as a former Rotaractor, I'd like to welcome you to Rotary. the main arm of Rotary. Rotary as a member of Rotary. And I've called a past district Rotary representative and our current DRRs to encourage other Rotaractors in the audience to do what you're doing by transitioning into the main Rotary. But I'm also happy that you're joining a very wonderful club, the Green Club. And I'm sure, as a member of this club, you're going to make a difference, to continue making a difference in Rotary. So I'd like to pin this lapel pin on you.
About this particular club. Why? Because this was the club that made me the Rotarian I am. We learned a lot from this Rotary Club. But I'm also very interested in where I came from. I came from the Rotaract Club of Kampala Central. And every time one of us shines, one of us, you know, becomes exemplary. For those of you who don't know, I was meant to be a district Rotaract representative. But when I didn't become, years later, the very first person who became a district Rotaract representative from the Rock was the young man standing next to me. First district district Rotaract representative Alan, now the president of all Rotaractors in Africa, is standing before us. Welcome to the Rotary Moment, and I'm so proud of you. I don't know how many people tell you, but I'm so proud of you. Now, I will give you the mic for you to tell us, what is this president of all Rotaractors in Africa? How can you help the Rotaractors in your district? How do you synergize with us as Rotarians? But most importantly, how do we grow Rock? How do we only not have Alan? How do we have other members become presidents of Africa?
Thank you very much, Carol, and thank you for having me today. It gives me pleasure to be speaking to you on the Rotary Moment show. I am yet also to get to settle in, in this President Rotaract Africa position. But yes, now Rotaract Africa, it's a multi-district information organization which brings together the 20 Rotary International districts in Africa, and that makes Zone 22. So, for you to become a Rotaract Africa president, you must have been a DRR. So you must be a past DRR. Rotary International has two types of membership. It has Rotary and Rotaract. Now, Rotaract is for the young people from the age of 18 to 30, 35. But then Rotary starts from there, though anyone from the age of 25 really can join Rotary. If they have the requirements. So Uganda, for the first time, has been privileged to have the President Rotaract Africa. And I am the first Rotaractor to be President Rotaract Africa. I've served as Vice President, but also I served as the first Board Chairman of Rotaract Africa, Mal-District Information Organization. So this brings the 20 districts of Rotary International in Africa. So that means I head the 20 districts. Now, at Rotaract is Rotaract President, Rotaract Africa President. Then in Rotary, we have the Zone Director, the RI Director. So my role here is President Rotaract Africa. And my role is to support with the executive, and the executive comes from all over Africa. The top executive is over 10 Rotaractors from all over Africa, and I'm the president leading these African Rotaractors. in over the 52 countries in Africa. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Fellow Rotarians, Rotractors, Interactors, and friends of Rotary, good evening. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome a very important person to this club. Our chief guest, I know many of you are here to have a glimpse on him, but we pride in him being part of us at the Rotary Club of Kampala Central. This is a leader who is passionate about what we are passionate about in the Rotary Club of Kampala Central. Our guest of honor is a lover of environment. The success and the story of the Rotary Club of Kampala Central in contributing to the environment, our guest of honor has been part of it. The Rotary Club of Kampala Central has planted many trees in this country, but a couple of years ago, our guest of honor led us at Nyenga Seminary, and we planted trees on 5 acres of land. And the trees we planted are not the usual trees. We actually planted indigenous trees because this was his desire. We did not only plant trees, but we are growing them. And our guest of honor has been very, very instrumental in contributing to the growing of those trees up to this level. Our guest of honor, I would like to report to you that the trees we planted in Nyenga Seminary have already defied the odd in terms of height. Because the last time when you are planting those tree seedlings, if you go there now, they are taller than you. And we want to thank you for that. Our guest of honor has not only stopped at contributing to the environment and projects that we are contributing to, but he has also been very passionate about giving to Rotary International. Our guest of honor has been part of our success in contributing to Rotary International as the Rotary Club of Kampala Central. But I would like to report to you, our guest of honor, that in last year's district conference, or DISCON, there is a young club that has no respect for old clubs. This club took us out of our comfort zone. We have always led in contributing to Rotary International in District 9213. But this time round, they beat us. And we are runners-up. And I said, while we congratulated them on that achievement, I promised to them that I quietly report them to our Council of Leaders that this is unacceptable and that next year we are going to show them what we are. And our guest of honor, I'm reporting that to you. And I know that when you come to your remarks, as an elder, you guide us accordingly. Our guest over tonight is Right Honorable Thomas Taebwa, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, with Mama Anita Taebwa. We want to welcome you warmly to this club. And we want to thank you for the generosity you have always showed to this club. As a last bit to show how passionate he is to the environment, our guest of honor agreed to celebrate his birthday with a green club in a forest near Nyenga Seminary, where we've been planting trees. And we know that he will continue supporting that forest up to the time it becomes of age. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome with me our guest of honor tonight, Right Honorable Thomas Taebwa and the wife. Thank you very much for coming.
Our guest of honor tonight, Right Honorable Deputy Speaker of Parliament, and your dear wife. Before I introduce our PE, I want to make a comment. The green you see around the tent is not in any way associated with the people you were, for whom you were best man on Saturday. Yes, this is a green club. And we are not associated with those guys. Our guest of honor, I'll stand on the protocol that has been observed. Let me take this singular honor of introducing our incoming president. Marion joined the Rotary Club of Kampala Central in June 2006. Yes, and she has been with the club for the last 18 years. She is a Rotarian who has served in several directorates, including club secretary and service projects, undertaking tree planting in communities, access to health projects, access to water projects. Marion has attended numerous district conferences, the famous one having been in Addis, Ethiopia. Those of you who remember the green bag. And as well attended RI conferences, and she was also in Singapore just a few weeks back. She is a Paul Harris Fellow and a Rotarian in good standing of the Rotary Club of Kampala Central. Most of you know she's closely associated with Uganda Breweries Limited, a company she worked for 13 years before joining Total Energies E&P Uganda, where she has served for the last 13 years. She has been a vice chairperson of GOGA, Ogayaza Old Girls Association, as well as chaired the famous UMA Holdings Limited. Where's PDG Xavier? You should clap for that. Our PE is a member of League of East African Directors, or LEAD, a leading governance institution whose mission is to equip boards of directors for the advancement of East African businesses. She serves on the boards of Uganda Clays, where she chairs the board finance committee, And she also serves on the board of UAP Insurance, UAP Mutual. Yes, she holds a Master of Business Administration from the University of South Wales, a Bachelor of Arts degree with a major in marketing from Coventry University in the United Kingdom, and attended the Strathmore University, Kenya, University of Navarra, ISE Business School Spain, in Spain, where she got an advanced management program and is a certified John Maxwell coach. Our PE is married to Rotarian Mark Muyobo, PHF, and he's from the Rotary Club of Chiwatuli. I think our in-laws are around here. Yes, and together they have three children, Manuel, Malcolm, and Marcella. Marion loves music and dancing. She's passionate about seriously growing, not just people, but also of trees. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you our president-elect, Marion Muyobo. We hope she's going to accept to be the president. Marion, please stand and come close. I would like at this moment to invite PDG Emmanuel down, our guest of honor. PDG Emmanuel will come and administer the oath of presidency to our PE.
May I take the honor to invite Mama Nita and Right Honorable Thomas Taibwa. Please, DGE, please walk them down. Right Honorable Thomas Taibo and Mama Nita. Now, my fellow Rotarians, please rise up as we do one of the best functions in our organization, is to recognize a very recognizable human being, a Rotarian, a superclass political leader, Right Honorable Thomas Taibwa. And I'll request the man who tested it all, Mike Sebalu, to do this.
Thank you very much, Governor Emmanuel Katongole, our host president. Thank you for the opportunity, and our governor in waiting, Anne, in our midst. It is good to do good in the world, for it is the right thing to do, and he who does good is acknowledged, appreciated, and recognized. And for that, on behalf of the Rotary International President, the trustees of the Foundation, Rotary Uganda, and all the governors here present, as well as the family of Rotary gathered here and beyond, I wish to decorate our newest Major Donor Level 2 in the names of Right Honorable Thomas Taibwa, together with his dear wife. Join me with a round of applause to receive him and celebrate him for his generosity and magnanimity.
Now, fellow Rotarians, when you are a major donor to the Rotary Foundation and you've got a supportive spouse, she is recognized along with you. I have been to their home many times. I have seen Mama Anita. You go there, they've got people who work for them, but she personally serves you with tea, with a meal, and you say yes, and popcorn. You say that, yes, these are the kind of leaders that we deserve. I would have loved to decorate her, but you know I fear to touch here. So I would request our incoming district governor, Anne Nkutu, to come and do the honors. Oh, now they are not seeing you. I think try to be.
To Anita, thank you for your generosity. They say sharing is caring. Thank you for sharing your family resources with people who you will never meet and people who may never have the chance to say thank you. So I say thank you on their behalf.
Yeah. Thank you, Anne. And when a lady is recognized, we know that ladies don't enjoy so much of a lapel pin. They enjoy a necklace. And I know Right Honorable Thomas Taiwa loves good things like I do. When he next travels, he will buy a very nice chain for Mama, so that Mama can always be putting it on. I request my brother Kenneth Mugisha to hand it over.
Right Honorable, you know, this one I'm not going to put it in the neck, otherwise you might hang me. But on behalf of Rotary International, and allow me to take this opportunity to pass over this to Anita, but also to tell you that we are seeing more challenges in this world, and 2025 is a very special year to our Rotary Foundation. We are looking at growing our giving to $2,025,000,000 by the year 2025, under that slogan of 2025 by 2025. We are looking forward to you as a family to support this cause, because we are looking at increasing impact in our communities through our donations and growing our endowment fund. Thank you.
Right Honorable, when you are a major donor, one of the most precious things that you get is a crystal that you can either put at home or in your office, but is inscribed with your name and the name of Mama Anita. Because it is so special and inscribed in there, I don't know how they do it, but the man who served us during COVID and did a splendid job, past district governor, Xavier Sentamu, will say a few words and hand over this.
Thank you so much, my brother, Emmanuel. Right Honorable and Mama Anita, thank you for your generosity. This crystal here comes from the Rotary Foundation of Rotary International. And on it, you can see that it's inscribed Thomas Taibwa and Anita Rukundo. And we're thanking you and appreciating your generosity for the many lives that you have touched and that you are yet to touch around the world. Congratulations again. Thank you so
much. Thank you so much. So leaders, I'm sorry for my young brother here. Right Honorable, you've heard of something called a Rotary Peace Concert. I started that, but I could not run it. I asked my young brother, Geoffrey Chitakure. This man ran the program to an extent when you are contributing to the Rotary Foundation. He reached out to 5 million people across the world. And Uganda is still a marvel within Rotary circles. Please shake. So please, governors, feel free to go back. Right honorable, please take your seat. Now, may I invite Marion and her dear husband, Mike, to come. Because the family is relatively large, you can come with your children, and the rest I'll invite them for a photograph after.
Yo, Vinka. This is unusual. Banga boy. Chitaka. There she go, go, go. A mama. Fire body killer. Cheza kidogo, kidogo. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ona tuku tuku mabe. Petaka kulu kulu my day. Easy, this your body. Go down low. Bibili bi bang, come closer. I'm burning, I'm burning. You kill me, oh yeah yeah. You know what I'm lacking, you're lacking. And you wanna give me all your love, yeah.
I will also invite President Francis to come and join me on this side. Please tell Right Honorable Deputy Speaker of Parliament, and all your fellow Rotarians, that you are going to do what Rotary has done best, that when you're a leader, you hand over authority to the next leader without a little bit of fight. Please tell.
Friends, I'll address myself to you and the Right Honorable Speaker. When you take over leadership and serve, and your time comes, forgive me, I don't know if these are the right words to use. I'm in the spot. When your time comes, you peacefully hand over power, and you facilitate transition, and service continues through someone else, and you stand behind them and support them. Thank you.
Now, Right Honorable Thomas Tayebwa, you are a Rotarian. Although Marion asked me to install her as president, please, please, with maximum respect, please join so that we do this together. Fellow Rotarians, could you please rise up? And to you, Francis, please willingly hand over that chain of authority to the Right Honorable Chief Guest. Now, fellow Rotarians, it is our greatest honor and privilege that Right Honorable Thomas Tayebwa and I install Marion Adengo Muyobo as the president of this Rotary Club. Marion, wherever you are in the house, you will be like, right honorable speaker is coming. A bell will be rung and everyone will rise for you. Can you please ring it for the first time so that they know your authority? Aha!
It's Vinka. Ah.
Marion is the president of the Rotary Club of Kampala Central.
I,
Marion Adengo Muyobo, do solemnly pledge to protect the Constitution of Rotary International and the bylaws of the Rotary Club of Kampala Central. I pledge to uphold the goals, mission, and objectives of the club. I further pledge to perform my duties as the president of the Rotary Club of Kampala Central to the best of my abilities in the service of Rotary. I pledge to work in a concerted effort with the club board and members to implement the club's strategic plan. Finally, I pledge to support our club in membership growth, the Rotary Foundation, vocational and youth services, so that we impact the communities that we serve. So help me God.
Keep that.
Dear past district governors, DGs, DGEs, DGNs, DGNDs, those people who are not following, eh? You join Rotary. AGs, PAGs, HCPs in the house, past presidents, magical president! Rotarians, Rotaractors, distinguished guests, honored friends, ladies and gentlemen, all protocol observed. Today marks a significant milestone in our history, in our club history, as we gather to usher in a new leadership team, and I thank God for this day. First and foremost, I want to express my gratitude to our outgoing president, Francis Wanji, for his dedication to our club, as well as my dear friend, who could not be here, DJ Kakembo, who I've known since my years at the brewery. I commend you and your team. My path to this club was guided by my auntie, the late Roseanne Ramporo, who was a member of this club. May her soul rest in peace. My auntie and I had so many friends in this club, many of whom have passed on. And I would like us to stand up and observe a moment of silence. May their souls rest in eternal peace. DG Anne, when we went for the pets, you asked us, president-elects, you remember, you asked us, it was in March this year, you asked us to write our handover speech. This is my handover speech. June 2025, you can see, four-way test. Remember, this is my handover speech, but I'll put it on the side and fill in the gaps. Thank you. Still have to say the words. With my team, guided by the district, we sat and drew a plan for the year 2024-25, starting on 1st July. The team presented it to the club at a retreat. There was enough time. And these plans were approved at a club assembly. So we really followed protocol. I strongly believe in divine intervention. And for me, I've really added up the dots. First District Governor Katongole talked about his relationship with my family. There are so many people here. If I were to really connect, it's amazing. Xavier, you've heard there was a connection. You'll hear about that a little bit later. It grew from Discon in Addis Ababa, but you'll hear about that a bit later. It is not I who decided what time and when. You've heard that. I've been with this club for many years, but this is the right time for me. When I listened to RI President Stephanie speaking, her words resonated with me. When DG Ann spoke about consolidation, sustainability, for a very long time, I've been struggling with these things. We are doing too many things. Why don't we consolidate for sustainability? So I really felt, by the way, the RI president is the first woman president. Then we've also got DG Ann. Then I'm a woman. So everything lined up. This club has committed to the 7 areas of focus with emphasis on the environment, because, by the way, I'm very passionate about the environment. My mom will tell you, one day I just woke up, I went to Kachumbala, and I planted a forest. That was, I think, 25 or 30 years ago. And it's there. The district has been given a target. Because we're celebrating 100 years, we have to subtract the age of the club. Kampala Central is 32 years old, so every club is supposed to subtract from 100 years, which we are celebrating next year in Jinja. So 100 minus 32 is 68. And DG Ann told us, multiply by 100, you get 6,800. DG Ann, our club has an audacious goal of surpassing that. We are going to plant 50,000 trees. We have to plant 50,000 trees. We also have disease prevention, water and sanitation initiatives, and a very strong maternal and child health program, because we have some global grants to execute. The club is going to focus on sustainability of its activities, the tree planting. Anita, the son, Right Honorable Taebwa, have been and planted trees with us. These trees are growing. The problem these days, we are just planting, then we go away after taking photos. But our trees, we get support from Right Honorable Speaker, and these trees are growing. On membership, our district governor, Anne, has challenged us that we need to attract, retain, and enhance member experience. And for us, this member experience is not just going to be at fellowship, but it's also going to be through these projects. On giving, if we do not give, how are we going to receive? So the Rotary Foundation is a big one for us. On governance and systems, we have a strategic plan, and we have bylaws. We have to follow these things. We have to consolidate all our activities, and I'm encouraging all other clubs to do the same. We have to focus on impact, and we have to sustain. Ladies and gentlemen, with all these things, which are very dear to my heart, it is at this juncture that I declare my acceptance to lead the Rotary Club of Kampala as its 32nd president in the year 2024-2025. I am humbled and honored to stand before you as the incoming president of the club and commit and pledge to work with everybody. I would at this point like to introduce my incoming team who are going to lead us.
And the 31st president finally decides to hand over the chair. I personally am very, very attached to this club, like I've said. But Francis, the president today, is also very, very, very close to me because of where we come from.
We come from the same Rotary Club. And I think if I had joined Kampala Central, I would be in the offing as well. So I know that it is one of those things that I would have loved to do. This is a club that I hold very dear to my heart. Welcome with me the president, the 31st president of the Rotary Club of Kampala Central, President Francis. He's going to tell us a word, give us a word or two about his year. What is that message that he wants to give to his club members? Then again, he has been president. Viewers, one of the things that is very interesting is that when you're handing over that chain, it is a sigh of relief. If you didn't know, because leading leaders is one of the most difficult things. But we go out and serve because we want to serve. So I would like him to give a message to his incoming president. What is that message that he wants to give to Marion as she takes over? And then what is it that President Francis would like his club members to do for Marion to succeed? President Francis, are you good for that? Congratulations for finishing an entire year. Congratulations for a wonderful installation. I want you to take us through what you have achieved this year and those things that you'd like to tell to Mario.
All right, thank you very much. My name is Francis Wanji. I'm the Hope Creator President for the Rotary Club of Kampala Central. I'm quite excited. One, because we've had a wonderful year of service. We've done quite a lot with my team, the board, and we've registered a number of successful events during this year. We started by hosting the district governor. It was a very, very exciting moment, and it was very successful. We've had medical camps held at Lukwanga in Wakiso, and this is basically to support the communities in need. And this is our Adopt Village project. We had the council run, we participated honestly, and from our contributions and contributions from partners, we were able to get quite some amount of money that has helped us to run our club projects. We had the Boy Child Uplifting Program event in Buija. Buija is located in PG District. And we had a number of primary school children to speak to about career guidance, about mindset change, about inspiration to stay in school. And these are all projects that make me very proud. We've had global grants confirmed and signed during this year. We have the Mother and Child Health Program, which is happening in 7 districts across Uganda. And this is a big project that we are already implementing. Then we have Chengera Women's Hospital. It's just been approved by the Rotary Foundation, and we are very glad that soon we'll be implementing this. And these are all success stories that I'm very proud of. And we couldn't have done this without the support of the board members, without the support of the advisors of the club. And I'm very glad that they have all been there to support us. The message I have for the incoming president, my sister P.E. Marion, is leading volunteers is quite different from leading members in an organization where they are paid to serve. And when the members are doing this without any payment, then you need to appeal to their personality. You need to appeal to their interests. But one thing I need to let you know is that these club members are committed. They are very passionate about service, and you just need to let them know how they can support you, and they will definitely support you. I also have to say I'm available to support my president. I'm ready to take the back seat and take leadership from my president. I'm ready to take direction from the president, and I really wish her the best term of service. We'll be there and want her to shine. We'll be there to ensure that she indeed shines.
Now, President Francis, you've done a wonderful job. 74 members, I mean, so many global grants.
78, actually.
78 members, yes. You also inducted one of our former presidents at the
Rock. No, that makes it 79.
79, yes. Wow, that's wonderful. Now, you you've got so many global grants. You have been outstanding at the district leadership. You had the Lieutenant Governor. You had the district web magazine editor who did a wonderful job. She even got an award.
Yes, Sheila.
You have done a wonderful job this year. Now, for me, I think as we conclude, do not stop at being president, please. Would we want to see you as assistant governor, please? The governor's out there. There's a very hardworking president here. And I think that the Kampala Central Rotary Club has a way of grooming Rotarians. And I think it is wonderful that you are president and you come from the Rock. Your parting shots, those three things that you'd like to see your club, where you want to see your club stand as of 2024, 2025, Jinja.
All right. Thank you very much. Of course, we are looking forward to the DISCON in Jinja, but where I would want my club to excel, one is togetherness, keeping the members together, because this is fun through fellowship. So I want club members to stay together, have fun as they serve. That's very important. The other area is I want us to excel as a club that runs grants successfully. I want to ensure that these grants are successful, we achieve the objectives of these grants, we submit our reports, we submit our financials, and we close these grants successfully. The other is I would like us to see the members and the club participating in more global grants, writing more grants, and having them implemented in our communities. And of course, the other is to have more members participate in our club events, projects, fellowships. I want to see a high percentage of members attending every weekly meeting. That's a very nice thing to handle. And if they all come on board, we shall enjoy the service and we shall be able to change our communities.
Wonderful. I stand here like a very proud little mother goose, but I'm very proud of you, Francis. Congratulations, and thank you for the outstanding performance. Thank you very much for allowing us to interview you.
Thank you. Yeah. Sir, I warmly welcome you and invite you to speak to us. Feel free to speak from any place you want to.
As a green club, we are investing in restoration of the environment through the planting of trees, starting with the one in Nyenga, for which I'm deeply attached. Like our club president said, sustainability. You know, sustainability is very critical. When we plant these trees, we need to have a budget to maintain them. I was at Nyenga when they were celebrating 100 years, and I found my trees which I planted to celebrate my birthday. We are doing extremely well. As a green club, I hope we can continue on this path, and our club's project, Save the River Nile, through the grant for the Nile Drive and maternal and child health care projects we are engaged in, have given us an opportunity to expand our services far and wide. Your leadership, Madam President, will be crucial in steering these projects of ours, galvanizing our membership, and expanding our outreach to those in need. Let us take a moment to acknowledge and celebrate the incredible journey that has brought us here. Rotary's strength lies in its members in offering education service and their collective effort to foster understanding, goodwill, and peace. The achievements of the past year under the capable leadership of President Francis Wang have set a high standard and laid a solid foundation upon which we can build for this year, Madam President, supporting. As we welcome our 32nd president and her team, let us commit ourselves to the core values of Rotary: service, fellowship, diversity, integrity, and leadership. Together we can continue to make a difference, one project at a time, one community at a time, and one life at a time. I extend my heartfelt congratulations and best wishes to our new president. May vision and leadership, inclusive growth, and transformative service mark your tenure. As we look to the future, let us do so with hope, determination, and a steadfast commitment to our shared goals. Because some of us, like me, you know, we work in a world which is so stressing, and we find solace in Rotary. I want to pay special tribute to my senior brother, Emmanuel Katongere, who has mentored me and enabled me and handheld me to grow in this journey. I'm used to giving. Like I told you earlier, I give not because I have much, but because I know the pain of not having, you know? And it's so interesting how much, you know, recently I have some few friends. So they came to know, they were looking for me. I think they are like doctor here. Yeah, they were looking for me. They looked for me, they called my phone. So my assistant told them, no, he's home up country. And I think he's resting. So they were shocked to see that I'm resting. So in around 2 hours, they were in a chopper and they were in my village. Are you okay? I said, yes, I'm okay. So, why are you hiding here? I said, no, I'm resting. So, but they found me with communities of women. I was shocked. I started a women's bank in the village, which we started with around 5 million in 2016 with my wife, in 2015. And now it has grown. The women have around 1.8 billion. And my share in that bank is 10,000 only. And our target was these women who would need 25,000 to buy seedlings, okay? But I was shocked how much people can give. It's a matter of bringing people on board. Madam President, it's a matter, many people want to give, but they don't know the power of giving. They don't know the relief that comes with giving. Being there and you just see a child being helped in Afghanistan, and you touch that child, even in America, which is the most developed. But many people in this country, they think they only give on fundraisings to build the churches, to build what? Then we politicians, every day I have around 10 invitations for giving. You give, but what are you giving for? I think Rotary has defined the purpose of giving. So friends, whatever little you have, just look around your friends, whatever little they have, they give. And here, I really love it, to find that I can come, I make a speech without us talking about the agenda of the country. But the agenda of a family that has no conditions. Thank you for loving us without conditions. I really, Fabian, me and Fabian have been together for long. I think Fabian for over 15 years. For long we've been a good friends. I see many of you, I saw Dan here, and I was glad to see your dear wife being on the executive. Claire Chirasha is my young sister. I married the sister. Yes. So I have been many
many people here whom I've seen, and I'm glad to be here. And in the spirit of Ubuntu and for continuity of Rotary's efforts of making the world a better place to live in, I've been challenged. I think Madame she first allowed me, because she's the one who signs. Let me tell you men, there is no better liberation you have than when you hand over money issues to your wife. No, I'm being honest, I don't know. I'm being honest. I can list to you my businesses, all of them, and you will find I don't sign anywhere. And since then, I've gotten peace, so much peace, because she's the one who accounts. Now, I send auditors at her. She doesn't send to me. And I've had peace, and businesses have grown better than when I was in charge. So I really want to appreciate my wife, and I advise men. You know, like they say, men are tempted most when they have money, and women are tempted most when they don't have money. So now... So now you can swap the roles of managing money, then both of you avoid temptations. Okay? Yeah, but anyway, I just wanted to say that last year we gave $25,000. Yes. I think chairman has challenged us, so we are going to increase it. This Marion, to the Rotary Foundation, we shall contribute $35,000. And then. For projects, I'll be looking at project by project. I see what we can be contributing. And on that one, I when it comes to financial matters, on how much can be there, me and Katongere, we usually check ourselves. Me and Emma, we usually get an evening where we share drink and we go through and we say, but why are you doing bad? Why are you doing bad? Ah, you made this much, we should celebrate. So I will ensure that I remain on the footsteps of past governor, past district governor Katongere. I can assure you, I find peace in Rotary. So I will do whatever I can to continue with that peace. I thank you.
I think for me, the first thing that we have to consider is that our children see this as an opportunity. Marcella, are you happy for mommy becoming a president of this club?
Very. I am very happy.
Are you proud that she's president of our Rotary Club?
Yes, I am very proud.
How are you going to help her become a better president?
I'm going to support her.
Now, any child who supports her parents, I think that is one of the few things that we need in Rotary. President Marion, congratulations. How does it feel to wear that chain?
Hey, it is a bit scary. When the chain was coming over, I was like, oh my goodness, it's finally here. I can't believe I'm wearing this chain. So it's going to be a good challenge, but I'm up for the next 12 months.
Wonderful. I have seen a side to Marion I had not seen. You dance, girl. You dance.
Dance dances. This girl dances at home all the time.
Oh, that's wonderful. And that's a cheery club, one that allows the Rotarians to feel at home. It is business, but with fun.
Thank you.
Are you going to be able to deliver all the things that you need?
Well, I think you heard. I told my board that it is them who has to deliver. I have all the faith in them. I picked them very carefully over 36 months. There were some changes, but I think I have the right team. So I believe that's how we are going to deliver, and every member has to participate. We shall deliver.
Wonderful. Congratulations. And you better support mommy. Thank you very much. For me, this makes a team, plus daddy and the boys.
Sorry?
This makes a team.
Oh, yes. Plus daddy and the boys, yeah.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. The guest of honor tonight has said Rotary gives him peace. Thomas Taewa tonight has told us how much he is at peace when he comes to Rotary. And we've seen a president take a chain, and she is very happy with what she has done. For me, I am home, because this club is home to me. Congratulations, President Marion. You are going to lead a team of 79. She said you want to eat 80. You definitely will. Congratulations. Congratulations to you taking the chain. And congratulations to Francis for a wonderful year. I can't say any more. I am overjoyed by seeing a woman take the position of president. My name is Carol Chazeka Koza, here at the Rotary Moment Show. I want to join you again, join us again on UBC next week on Tuesday, and join us on YouTube. On our YouTube channel, you can join us on Facebook, you can join us on WhatsApp, and you can tweet. Make sure that you send us a comment or two. Rotary gives me peace. Those are one of the wonderful words that Thomas Taewa has given us today. I think for me, he has explained what Rotary is to many of us. Rotary is home. Rotary is where we serve and feel that whatever we've given, that $1 means something. I remain Carol Chazeka Koza here at the Rotary Moment Show.
For the wonderful fellowship we've had this evening, let's toast to Rotary International.